I'm very proud that we did, was smart enough to hire him, but I already knew that. Buddy Baldwin, he is a key guy, and I'm sure he wanted Roy, and when I suggested, you know, that he come with us, I think Buddy was great and said, you should go.
I knew when he was in high school in the 10th grade, he said, Coach, I want to coach someday. Very coachable. He, very smart. Had basketball sense, and that's something that you can't coach. That's something that people have or they don't have. Very competitive and was just a very hard worker, very honest. And he made the comment to me one time, I've never forgot it, when he got into coaching as a head coach. He said, they may outcoach me, but they won't outwork me. And he recruits hard, he works hard. And, you know, I don't care, as a coach, you've got to have good players, and but you've got to work to get them. And then when they get there, as a coach, you've got to create chemistry and everything among the players, and that's the toughest job for a coach. Because he's got great players, but yet they have to be able, you have to blend them, they have to have the chemistry to play together, and that's where he's good. I don't know, Roy just, we just sort of bonded, I guess, as a friends. And like I say, he's done more, now he won't admit this, he won't tell you this, but he's done more for me than I could ever do for him. And what he allowed me to do is something that people, you know, I love coaching, I really, really love coaching. But he allowed me to watch a young man that I coached. I've been able to follow his career from the time he started as a high school coach at Owen High School till he's inducted into the Hall of Fame in Springfield, Massachusetts. Not many people can say that.
The enthusiasm, the energy he has about his alma mater is so unique and so special. Roy Williams took him to that national championship. Yes, they hung the banner high. He came back to his university, and what a job he has done. One of the great coaches in the history of the game, my friends. Think about it. He's already enshrined in the Basketball Hall of Fame. And I know to Roy Williams, you people here are all Hall of Famers. He loved Asheville, loved everything about it, and growing as a coach, a teacher, a motivator, as someone who inspired people. Roy Williams, to me, is one of the biggest winners ever to grace the sideline. And what makes him a true Hall of Famer, he cares about people. He cares about the kids he coaches. They become very special in his life. I want to simply say, congratulations, Roy. You are awesome, baby, with a capital A. If I were talking about you on TV now, I'd say you're the 3S man. Super, scintillating, sensational. A PTP, a primetime performer. God bless. Have a great, great evening.
You know, in the seventh grade after school every day, my friends and I would stop at a gas station. They would have a Coke, and I didn't because I didn't have the dime. My mom found out about that, and it really bothered her. Times were very difficult, but she took in laundry and ironed people's clothes at night to get extra money. So the next morning on the kitchen table, there was a dime there, and there was a dime there every morning after that. I suppose it's because of her that I keep so much Coke around.
If you know Roy, when he tells you something, that's what he means. He's truthful. If he tells a player, a mother, a father something, it's the truth. And then he's probably as tenacious as anybody you've ever met.
Roy, I truly treasure your friendship. I truly treasure all the thrills that I have had as a result of you coaching. And I appreciate being able to attend the games when you were at Kansas, the games at Chapel Hill. You have prolonged my life, and I thank you.
Roy had a lot of things about him that the average person did not have. He taught me a lot. Roy taught me about responsibility and loyalty. Probably, Roy's treatment of players and former players and his loyalty to them, his loyalty to his former friends, and, well, they're all still his friends. He doesn't have former friends. They're all still his friends. Those things, plus he had a love for his family, and he and concern for them, especially his mother. When I taught at Robertson High School, Roy was a student there, and I picked up Roy and brought him to school every morning. I drove by his house. And that's when I learned a little bit about Roy to start with, that I didn't have to wait on him sleeping. He was always outside waiting when I picked him up.
Honest, sincere, loyal. Roy's got tremendous drive. He's always been, you know, he's probably the type of guy that if you're playing checkers with your sister, you play to beat her. So that's just the kind of drive he's got.
He knew what he wanted to do, I think, from the time he was about 8 or 9 years old. And it never changed. He had opportunities to go to other schools on full scholarships. But he knew what he wanted to do. And even while he was still in at Carolina, I think he spent a lot of time in the gym watching Coach Smith, and I think he learned a lot of what he does from Coach Smith.
I'm very proud of these accomplishments, but the thing that I'm most proud of, Roy, is the fact that you have never forgotten your roots nor forgotten your friends. A lot of those friends that played basketball with you at Biltmore Gym or that played golf with you at Muni, I think I speak for all of them when I say thanks for being the man you are and still remaining the man that you were.
Roy, the other night when I went over there to the T.C. Robertson Hall of Fame, all the inductees were very special. You'd have to be special to make any kind of Hall of Fame. But when your name came up and you started talking, I got the feeling I'm going to lose it. I felt so much pride. So, I just love you, and I loved you as a player for me, Roy. Good luck at Chapel Hill. Hope you win the NAA. Oh, I'm glad you beat Duke for the ACC title.
Well, Roy always was a go-getter. He was a little short fella, a little short, long-haired fella in high school, and he was always the first to be on the bus to go somewhere, always the first. So I kind of figured Roy would wind up in the position that he's in now.
Well, he's very loyal. He remembers his friends from way back. He doesn't pick his friends because of who they are. Or their status and or money or anything like that. He picks them because they're just good friends. I hate to say this, but he learned a lot from Buddy Baldwin and Coach Smith. Obviously, a lot of his coaching ideas come from Coach Smith, but he's extremely competitive, but he does it the right way. Has impeccable credentials, and he wins the way you should win.
I would describe Roy as a CEO. His ability to manage a major university basketball program with the level of success is tremendous. He could manage any organization if he put his mind to it. For example, Coca-Cola. His ability to delegate responsibilities down to his assistant coaches and staff. His ability to handle the alumni, deal with the media and boosters. He could do it at any level.
Well, we both played for Buddy Baldwin at Robertson, and Roy was a few years ahead of me, just 3 or 4 years ahead of me. And then I became the head basketball coach at Robertson after Buddy, and Buddy and I were the only two coaches there for 40 years. And then I was fortunate to have two kids who have played for Roy. Christian Moody went to Kansas and played there, and now Patrick's at Carolina.
And also, I want to say I'm going to wear this vest. When I wear it every morning after you've won the game the night before. And everyone here at Arbitrary certainly knows why I'm wearing it. And when I don't wear it, I said there was no game. So really, Roy, I depend on you. Don't let me down, boy. All I want to do is say, go, go, Tar Heels. God bless you. Love you.
Well, I'm just real proud of you, Roy. You and Wanda both. Yeah. Well, I told him that he might think about eating because I knew Buddy had had a rough time going to Carolina and then starting coaching in, you know, in high school and all. And I thought maybe I could get Roy to make a decision quicker. Worried me because I didn't want him to give up his scholarship to Georgia Tech if that's what he wanted to do. So I sort of threatened him. I told him, well, he might someday have to come and get a loaf of bread from me to be able to eat.
You are a superb person. I remember you from the first grade up. And you have been an achiever. You've been wonderful to work with. And we're just so proud of you as Bee is, honey.
Hi, Roy. I wish I could be with you tonight. This was a great film photo shoot, and I will never forget it. And I just wish I could be there to touch you.
Roy, we were real proud of you and Wanda both. Keep it up, and we'll be watching you.
Most definitely, Roy. We're pulling for you all the way because we knew what you were made of and your goals in life. And we're just so proud of you. You keep the good work up. The Lord has been good to us.